Meet little Billy.
Where the heck am I?
Today he's going to learn the right way to build a modern AV system.
Oh, you mean like video calls and loudspeakers and stuff?
Not exactly. Different installations have varying demands for audio, video, and control. Could be as small as a coffee shop or retail store, or as large as a major theme park, corporate campus, or sports stadium. Just as an example, let's look at a meeting room, little Billy.
Oh, my name's not Billy.
Sure it is, little Billy. Here's just some of the components needed to equip this room to make audio and video calls.
That's a lot of different hardware components.
You know, the technical term is a complete mishmash of disparate components. Audio processors, video routers, control systems, protocol converters, conferencing cameras, proprietary network protocols, everyone made by a different manufacturer, and none were designed to work together. Pretty special, huh?
What?
Now it's your job to figure out how to make them work. Have at it, kiddo.
These clearly don't go together. I don't know how to do this.
Don't worry. Neither does your IT team. You need an integrator or programmer to resolve the mishmash, instead of letting them focus on solving real customer problems. Go on, pay the man, little Billy.
What, like with my own money?
Hurry up, he's paid by the hour.
I don't get it. All of this for just a few conference rooms?
A few conference rooms? You want more than one, little Billy?
Hey, stop calling me that.
For that, you'll need more processors. Here, here, and here. Oh, you missed a few. Don't worry. Each room needs to be designed from scratch. None of them will speak to each other, and you have no way of easily monitoring them all. Isn't that fun?
No, it seems really expensive and inefficient, both from a hardware and design perspective.
Don't worry, little Billy. As soon as your organization tries to scale up and add new functionality, you'll need to rip and replace some of it. Come to think of it, probably all of it.
Why do you keep saying don't worry? Everything you've said sounds terrible.
Well, that's the way it is, little Billy.
But why?
Because that's the way it's always been, little
Billy. Hi, are you talking to that narrator guy?
Yeah, he's got me all confused about modern AV.
Yeah, nobody likes that guy. What's your name?
Patrick.
Little Billy.
Nice to meet you, Patrick. Have you heard of Q-SYS from QSC?
No.
Okay, so Q-SYS is an integrated audio, video, and control platform. It starts with things like this, a solid IT-centric architecture and a standard network infrastructure. If you look on the inside, you'll see things you probably recognize. Intel processors, enterprise servers, Linux, IEEE network protocols. These are the technologies that you normally depend on to make your infrastructure work, and they are the basis for the Q-SYS AV real-time operating system.
Well, that makes sense to me.
Yeah, so what that means is you can, with Q-SYS, make a standard AV room, put that in the data center, and then scale up from there to grow along with your system.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Well, what about this guy?
Well, because Q-SYS is standards-based, it's a lot easier for your IT team to manage the little things and troubleshooting. That leaves this guy free to spend his focus on making a better AV experience for everyone.
Oh, well, I like that. Okay, well, what about all of this stuff?
Well, Q-SYS takes all of these devices normally associated with disparate audio, video, and control hardware.
My boxes!
And replaces them with an integrated software platform.
What's that?
Well, do you have your phone on you?
Yeah, it's right here.
All right.
Where do you put the nickels?
Is that guy still here?
Unfortunately. So your phone is an integrated software platform. You don't carry a whole bunch of hardware components with you, right? You don't have a calculator in your pocket and a video game console in your pocket and a GPS unit, right? You just download those features onto your phone. That's the same thing as with Q-SYS. And because Q-SYS uses Intel processing, we have an enormous amount of headroom for all of the features, not only that you're going to be using today, but all the features that you may add and license in the future.
Yeah, you can't just get rid of all hardware.
He's right. What about all the loudspeakers and amplifiers and cameras and touchscreen?
You still have all of those AV endpoints, but the good news is that QSC makes them all too. We have an entire ecosystem of peripherals that are designed to work seamlessly with the Q-SYS Enterprise platform. And for the endpoints that we don't make, well, you can use Q-SYS as the on-ramp for all the control and management of them. Let's keep going.
There's more?
Well, of course there's more. This is more than just meeting rooms. This is about retail stores and theme parks, movie theaters, convention centers, airports, you name it.
Wait, there's Q-SYS platforms for this stuff too?
No, there's one Q-SYS platform, and it scales from the small enterprise to the large one.
That's actually pretty nifty.
Q-SYS is in some of the largest installations in the entire world, and it has been for years. Anywhere that you want to install, configure, and manage AV, we can be there, including here.
Where the heck am I?
The future! Sort of. You want a company that is going to be prepared for tomorrow's challenges, right?
Yeah, sure.
Well, Q-SYS are the innovators of the future. Their engineers basically invented configurable DSP and networked audio. And they were the first ones to take AV software and put it on an off-the-shelf server. Their IT-centric software-based architecture
means that Q-SYS can scale into the future, right?
That's right.
Like for plug-in development for devices that don't even exist yet?
That's the ticket, yeah.
How about global remote monitoring and management of AV?
Hey, even narrator guys got it.
You guys, Q-SYS is the bee's knees.
Keep trying, narrator.
To learn more about the Q-SYS platform, go to qsc.com/Q-SYS.